Hello students, I am happy to meet you all through this video. In the previous video, we discussed how the CPU is connected with the I/O devices. The I/O devices are connected with the CPU through an interface unit and the I/O bus. The CPU is not only connected with a memory unit, but it also connected with the I/O devices. Today, let us see how the memory unit and the I/O devices are connected with the CPU. The CPU is connected with the I/O device through I/O bus and the memory unit through memory bus. The CPU transfer data to memory through memory bus and to the I/O devices through I/O bus. The memory bus also contains data lines, address lines and control lines similar to I/O bus. So the CPU consists of two buses, I/O bus and memory bus. These buses can be used in three ways depending upon the organization. In some computers, there are two buses, one for memory and other for I/O devices. And it may be one common bus for both memory and I/O device with separate control lines. And the third type is one common bus for memory and I/O device with common control signals. Many computers use the second type of configuration, that is one common bus with different control signals. So this diagram represents one common bus that is used to connect both memory and I/O devices with the CPU. Since the computers use one common bus, it is necessary to distinguish the data transfer between the memory and I/O devices. So this distinction is made by using separate read and write lines. For I/O transfer, the signals used are I/O read and I/O write. For memory transfer, the signals used are memory read and memory write. Not only this, every computer system consists of address space. There are two different address spaces. They are called I/O space for I/O devices and memory space for memory devices. Depending upon this address space, there are two types of configurations. They are isolated I/O and memory mapped I/O. Now let us discuss about the first type, that is isolated I/O configuration. In the isolated I/O configuration, the CPU has separate instructions and address space for I/O operation and memory operation. The instructions used for I/O operation are in and out, and the instructions used for memory operations are load and store. When the CPU do the I/O operation, it places the I/O address on the common bus and enables either I/O read or I/O write control signal. On the other hand, when the CPU do memory operations, it places the memory address on the common bus and enables either memory read or memory write control signals. Thus, in an isolated I/O configuration, CPU uses separate address space for memory and I/O devices. The second type of configuration is memory mapped I/O configuration. In memory mapped I/O, same address space and same instructions are used for both memory and I/O operations. It also employs only one set of read and write signals. The computer treats the interface units of the I/O devices as being part of the memory system. That is, a part of the memory space is allocated for I/O devices also. There is no separate I/O space for I/O devices. The advantage is that the instructions used for reading and writing from memory can also be used for IO operations. That is, the memory instructions load and store are used for both reading and writing from IO devices as well as from memory. Thus, in memory mapped IO method, the computer uses single address space, that is the memory space, and same set of instructions, that is load and store, and only one set of control signals for both memory and IO operations. To conclude, the processor communicates not only with IO devices but also with memory unit. The processor communicates with IO devices through IO bus and with memory through memory bus. Many computers use one common bus to transfer information between memory or IO and the CPU. Depending upon the address space used, there are two types of configuration: isolated IO and memory mapped IO. In isolated IO method, CPU uses separate address space for memory and IO operations. But in memory mapped IO method, the computer uses single address space, same set of instructions, and only one set of control signals for both memory and IO options. Thank you for listening. If you have any doubt, you can contact me over the phone or through mail. Thank you.